patiently waiting for the stream of faith which brings life forever. The man of tomorrow.
Hi, welcome to another update video from Rob's backyard. It's a bit of a close-up of the two camera angles now, which are live 24 hours. We do have a third one as you look on the website, but we have been struggling with that camera. The hydro system from the wall outside is now indoors. Of course, you'll have seen this if you've been following the how-to videos. And this is just great stuff, you know. We've got peppers and beans. We've had loads, and this has all come from one little plant on the back. So we've had loads and loads of beans off it. Peppers, chili peppers, bell peppers. This monster's producing just hundreds of tomatoes underneath it. So good stuff. This pot is the one where we showed you how to get started in hydro for £10. And the truth of it is, you can build two of them for that. The most expensive part is your pump. That's the dearest bit. So once you have a pump, you're away. Basil's doing all right now. We brought it indoor, temperature issues there. So yeah, these are doing okay. Had a bit of a drip here. Kind of sorted that actually. That's been in there all day, all night, and it's slightly damp, so it's I think I'm probably just gonna leave it for now. Anyway, outside I've placed these pots now up on the wall. It's just chives and bits and pieces. We've not really done much with these this year. It's the last flower. Now that space we've made there, we're hopefully I'm gonna get another tank up on that wall, and hopefully, again, there's a lot of hope here, it will be this one, because it's got dual outputs, you see. I will change the bell from the centre, put it on this side, and it should then drain down the side of the wall. So, excuse me, while I'm here, I'll just show you this tape measure. I hope you can see the measurements on there. That's 105 inches to the medium. I put this in because there's a lot of people out there with big tomatoes. I just thought I'd show you. No camera tricks here. And I'll take it outside so you can see the top of the tape. Oh, that's our cherry tomato. It's called Sun Golden. As you can see, it's having no problems producing fruit. Now, I've grown these along the ground in the past. Not this variety, but other varieties. Of cherry tomato, well, any vine tomato, any of them. I think I'll have to eat this one. Excuse me, I'll indulge myself. So what you can do is you can re-root a tomato if it's running along the ground. And I was kind of up about there-ish thinking about rooting it into the top, so I may do that really soon. So I just let me go outside. It's around the back here, and I can show you the angle and up on the tomato, so you can see that the tape measure, at least I hope you can see that. In fact, I'll do a bit of a zoom here, so I hope you can see the cherry tomato and the top of the tape measure up there. It is, that's our colossal tomato. This is a natural one we just have in. It's got, they're all English wildflowers, as we're normally kind of do along the back here. This tomato we struggled with right on the early on. It's really, but it's still, you can see it's living, it's doing all right, it's starting to cast some more flowers. A bit concerned about the lateness of these. As you can see, these are the ones we grew from seed. These are now starting to produce lots of fruit. Our beans, look, there's another bean. Some of the beans did make it. We are now getting some beans. Peas, you can see here. Again, we had awful problems with slugs and snails. I may have actually found a solution. types of sloping snails, and you can see there that there are many flowers coming, so we should get quite a lot of bees if the frost doesn't get us. So, oh, I don't think I've ever shown you this. This is where I produce chickweed. It is feed. This is an old Belfast stone sink I use for raising my aqua plants. There's also another weed here. So yeah, it just sticks to your hand. I'll get a little more actually. I'll just show you how easy it is if you just put your hand in. The drier your hand when you put it in, the better. And then you can just place it back in there. And you'll be able to see that. Hope you can anyway. Well, we're here. Gravel now in the bottom of the tank. Right gravel, obviously, do the tests. So we've planted in a little bit more here. Raised this up. To be honest, it makes it a much better shot from the camera. That's the camera you can see on the website. We've covered what is that? 105 inches. That's just short of 9 foot. Oh, tomato there. This, believe it or not, is spinach. It's the weirdest spinach plant I've ever seen. We've been harvesting it and harvesting it. It started to flower. I picked off the flowers, and it seems to have started to grow again. I'm not quite sure if it's going to start to throw some kind of seed, but strange looking plant. This is a lettuce variety, very similar to a rocket. Again, this is beginning to flower. So I'm almost ready now for clearing this tank completely. Let's say I want to let the tomato finish, and this one hopefully I will put up on the wall. Our bottom tank, this is still empty. I haven't got all the gravel out of it. That gravel is the one which was causing us problems with the pH. So I can just finish it. The only problems I have ever had with these bell siphons is roots growing through into the bottom. That's it. Not had any others. We use the cutter every now and then. The examples we've actually showing you on video aren't too clever with the root cutters, but again, just as simply, you just turn this bottom part, this outer shroud, cuts the roots, and then they will wash through the system. That works. I'm really pleased with the root cutter. Gonna also need to sort out my pumps. This is quite a large pump in here. I think it's 6,000 litres it does, and at the moment this little pump we've got, which is actually sat on one of the square terracotta pots to rise it up slightly, so it's not sat right on the bottom, you can't actually push enough water all the way up. See, it comes out of a pipe here and feeds round to the top tank, and there's not quite enough water to trigger the siphon back into here. So I need to sort that out. It is still trickling through all the time and it's working, but it needs sorting out. Because as I mentioned in a previous video, I need to put another overflow in. So my old saw that I was using isn't very good, so I need to purchase a new hole saw to put a second overflow, maybe even a third. Oh, let me show you this. In here we have a fish. One fish. You'll probably not be able to see it. It's right down there. I hope you can. I came out one morning and that fish was on the floor here, the side of the grid. I thought it was dead. I went to pick it up to dispose of it, and it moved in my hand, and I put it in here. It had no, it got fungus all over it. It had no tail, virtually no fins. What I do want to report to you now is that it's got a tail. All the fungus is gone. It does look like it's going to recover. So yeah, a few have asked what this is for. suppose. Well, it's a quarantine tank, you could call it. But at the moment, when I clean this out, it may have a big large tank to swim around in. Or maybe if it does carry on recovering, I'll release it into this pond. Now, one of the issues I've had is these are females. These are females. The male fish that are predominantly in here now, and it's those large ones, the perfect example there for you, they get very feisty. Not that one, that's one of the older fish, they're okay. And they were literally loving the females to death. They were getting really badly bruised and damaged. So as they've started, as the males have started to chase them around, I've transferred the females into here. And they're breeding, that's what's happening. Here we have got the other sun gold tomato. Now, this is the one that's been in hydro. It's about 6 foot, this one now. About 6 foot tall. And according to my friends, these are the tastiest tomatoes in the world. And if anybody wants one as a sample, you're welcome to call round. Well, we've still got them. And you can eat one directly from the vine. We will prove it. That bit you want. This piece below it is what they call a sucker. So normally, you take that out. Just pinch it out. And you see here? Just get rid of it. And leave the ones on the main side leaf. The main side leaf stays and you take out little suckers. Now, what you can do is allow them, seeing like this one here, and I'm going to have a go with it on this one. What you can do is you can allow them to grow on a little bit. Just a little bit. Allow them to get like 3, maybe 4 leaves. Then take them off. Cut them off. A cloning agent, or a rooting powder, something like that. And then pop them into a medium and they'll re-root and you can grow this again just from the sucker. Now, it's a bit late in the season to be explaining that and doing it, but I understand our audience is worldwide, so I will show you a few. I'm going to allow a few to grow, you see, a few of these suckers or side tubes. Oh, there's one there now, look, we can even have a go with this one, it's quite long, you know. The reason you take these off is rather than the plant put its energy into the fruit, it puts it into growing the side tube. Which is okay if you're running along the ground rather than up a wall, you can peg it down, and it'll root. It'll root again, and you can go along the ground and along the ground and along the ground. And we'll have a go at that next year. See how long we can get one single tomato plant. Well, here we go now, indoors. And I think that's about the end of our tour. We've done a 360 degree of our little backyard. So as always, I hope it helps. Ask us what you don't know, and tell us what you do.
Strike with knowledge, oh children. Within I know, I rock is a solid foundation. Jah is our guide through creation. Have faith, bow patiently waiting for the stream of faith which brings life forever. The man of tomorrow.